Welcome to MediSimplified. Today we'll start with the topic of ENT known as otosclerosis. Otosclerosis, it is also known as otospongiosis. It is a disease of bony labyrinth. Here we see that in the bony labyrinth we have a endochondral layer of otic capsule, which is replaced by irregularly placed spongy bones, which leads to fixation of stapes, which results in conductive type of hearing loss. This disease is mainly seen in females when comparing with males. The age group which are at a higher risk of this disease is from 25 to 45 years of age, but most of the cases are seen in between the age of 20 to 30 years of age. This disease is mostly present bilaterally. It is seen in white races, more specifically Caucasians. It is an autosomal dominant type of hereditary disease. There are three types of otosclerosis. First, stapedial. Second, cochlear. Third, histological. Okay, now we'll discuss each type one by one. First, the stapedial type. In this, the spongy bone gets deposited near the oval window, which leads to conductive type of hearing loss. The second type, that is the cochlear type. Here the spongy bones get deposited near the round window, which leads to sensorineural type of hearing loss. The third type, that is the histological type. This type is usually asymptomatic. And the lesions are seen usually after doing the postmortem. In histopathology, the earliest characteristic present is blue mantles. These are the three types. Once again, the stapedial type, cochlear type, and histological type. In stapedial type, the spongy bones get deposited near oval window, which leads to conductive type of hearing loss. The cochlear type, here the spongy bone get deposited near round window, leads to sensorineural hearing loss. And histological type, which is usually asymptomatic, which is there is no hearing loss, and the lesion is usually seen after doing the postmortem. We'll discuss the signs and symptoms of otosclerosis. First, we'll start with the symptoms. The otosclerosis is present with a very special symptom, which is known as paracusis. We'll see. In this, the person hears better in a noisy surrounding. Second, we see hearing loss. We have three types in which the histological type is asymptomatic. So if it is a cochlear type of otosclerosis, then we'll see sensorineural hearing loss. If it is a stapedial type, then we'll see conductive type of hearing loss. Third is vertigo and tinnitus. These both symptoms are seen only in cochlear type of otosclerosis. And the last, that is the speech of a otosclerotic patient, is soft speech, well modulated, and monotonous. Now we'll discuss the signs. First we'll see the tympanic membrane through otoscopy. In otoscopy we see normal tympanic membrane. But in some rare cases, a flamingo pink blush is seen. Flamingo pink blush is seen through the tympanic membrane, which is known as Schwartz's sign. Schwartz's sign. When we'll perform tuning fork tests, the Raine's test is negative for otosclerosis. Raine's test is negative for otosclerosis. The Weber's test, it is lateralized to the ear with higher amount of conducting hearing loss. Lateralized to ear with more conducting type of hearing loss. Then the third, that is the ABC test. In ABC test, usually we will find normal. The ABC test is normal, but in some cases, like if it is a cochlear type of otosclerosis, it will be reduced. That is, the sound will be reduced. We'll also do pure tone audiometry. Pure tone audiometry. Here we'll see Cahill's notch. Okay, now we'll discuss about the treatment of otosclerosis. In treatment, usually we perform surgery. Two types of surgery is done in otosclerosis: stepedectomy, and second, stepedotomy. In stepedectomy, we remove the foot plate of stapes. And replace it with a prosthesis. This was earlier used as a treatment of choice, but now it has been replaced with stepedotomy. What we do in stepedotomy, we make a hole in the foot plate of stapes. And we insert a Teflon prosthesis between the incus and foot plate of stapes. And stepedotomy is now treatment of choice for otosclerosis. Okay, surgeries are usually contraindicated in patient with associated Meniere's disease. It is contraindicated in pregnant women, in children. It it is contraindicated with patient having only single hearing ear, that is only one ear is normally functioning. It is contraindicated in diverse and frequent flyers. So in such patient we prescribe hearing aid. Hearing aid consists of three parts: microphone, amplifier and receiver. And there are three types of hearing aid. First is bone anchored, conventional and implantable. In case of otosclerosis, we usually prefer bone anchored hearing aid. Thank you for watching the video. This was otosclerosis. Please like, share and subscribe our channel MediSimplified.